Hey everyone, you're listening to Kinda Tempted.
I'm Kim-Mai.
And I'm Tanisha.
And today we're kinda tempted to trick or treat. Yay! I'm so excited for this episode.
You guys believe that we forgot about holidays though?
We really did. If y'all haven't noticed, we plan our episodes extremely in advance. So I was like looking at our calendar and I was like, oh shit. Actually, we're kind of in a rut. We're like, damn, what do we talk about? And then I was like looking at our calendar, like, oh shit, Christmas. Like, should we talk about Christmas? Should we talk about Halloween? All of these fun things. And so yeah, we're doing that.
Dude, like, thank God Kim-Mai remembered holidays, because if we got to October and we were like, oh shit, Halloween, we would already have episodes planned until like December. So
I know.
If we're pulling back the curtain today, it's mid-August right now, you guys, that we're recording a Halloween episode.
It's like kind of hot, but it's fine. You know, anything for the fans.
Sweating and turtleneck and onesie, yes.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if y'all aren't watching this, Tanisha and I, we kind of, you know, changed up the scenery. Not really the scenery, but the lighting, our outfits. Tanisha is a floating head over there with some lights.
I am
an owl, which is spooky for me, so... We're all types of costumes today just to be festive for this Halloween episode, if y'all didn't get what this episode is going to be about.
Today, we're going to talk about Halloween. We're going to talk about our stories and traditions and some other spooky shit. So stay tuned.
Yes. Okay?
Don't click off.
Don't
leave. It's going to get better. But since we're talking about Halloween today, how do you feel about Halloween, Kim-Mai?
I do think that I like it. I like Halloween. Yes, I do. I thought about like looking up the history of Halloween to like have that kind of information in this episode. Ooh. But then I also thought like, nah, you know, like Tanisha told me that she hates history. So maybe she would have also cut off my head if I did that. So y'all are interested in the history of Halloween, you can Google it, or maybe we can tell the story next year.
Yeah. Dude, but, I know she's right about history. Yeah. Like when I hear dates, like my eyes glaze over and I forget what's going on. But that's okay. Yeah, we'll talk about All Hallows Eve next year.
Yeah, so Halloween. I do enjoy Halloween. I think it's really fun to dress up, get some candy. And I think this is like a holiday that most people that I'm around in my community celebrate. So it's like a community thing. There's like community events, school events. We'd have like in elementary school, we'd have Halloween costume parades, and that was like so cute, you know? And I think that like any celebration or like festivity that makes the days feel a little bit more special, like that's always fun, you know? Instead of walking into work with no festivities, I'm walking into work with some pumpkins, some streamers.
Wow.
And what a great day that is, you know? And also people like decorate their houses and shit, like jack-o'-lanterns. Those are cool.
Yes, they are cool. I totally get what you mean, you know, when there's like a little different kind of vibe going on, like it's a little more exciting. The day is a little more fun. I definitely love all the spooky vibes and love Halloween. She's cute. Okay. But I'm not like a hardcore Halloween or holiday person, but I will feed off the energy of like everybody else who's like having a good time. You know what I mean?
She's stealing children's energy over there. That's what
Oh my God.
there she is, the floating head. Watch out.
Yes. Spooky Nisha today. But like what you were saying, like I love seeing people enjoying themselves. I love seeing little kids like thinking like it's the best fucking day ever and like eating candy and shit. And like, have you guys ever seen child wonder in their eyes? Okay. Like everything is like so new and amazing. And I'm just like, this fucking beautiful.
Yeah.
That's why I like holidays. Okay.
Yeah. That's great. That's I mean, like, yeah, that's like, that's really great. It's just like when you said child wonder, I was thinking you were referring to like a movie or something. I'm like, bitch, I've never seen that movie.
I have also not seen that movie. Childlike wonder. There we go.
There you go. Not child wonder.
not child wonder. Yeah, so while I'm busy stealing energy from children, the fun of it too is that you can be anything you fucking want for that day. Yeah, and nobody's gonna judge you, and if they do, they fucking suck. Okay,
like don't suck.
Don't suck unless you're a vampire, then that's cool, you know what I'm saying?
No, also don't suck, like leave other people's blood alone.
We are peaceful vampires, I guess. I feel like a lot of families have Halloween traditions. Did your family have any?
I mean, I don't think we had traditions. I think like my family would celebrate it because my parents would celebrate it just because they had kids, you know, like in school, they'd give me like candy to give out to classmates and they'd get costumes for me and stuff. Like, I think it was mostly in elementary school where we did a lot of these traditional things that you would do for Halloween. So we would go trick-or-treating, we'd do jack-o'-lanterns, make jack-o'-lanterns, we've been to like pumpkin patches, things like that. But it was never like every year we did it. It was like just trying different things every year, you know. I think my parents probably, I don't know, like did they celebrate Halloween in Vietnam back then? I don't know. Maybe I need to look into the history of that.
Maybe we all need a history lesson. Okay. My family is pretty much the same way. We're celebrating it because I am a child.
Yeah. Right?
And that is what you do to entertain your child when she's like, how come we don't get to go outside to trick or treat, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah, we would carve jack-o'-lanterns, we would go trick-or-treating. But other than that, it was just like, let's find the child a costume so she will stop talking so much.
And then exactly.
We can get on with like the winter holiday.
Yeah. And I think like what was like the big Halloween store, like Spirit or something?
Yeah, Spirit.
Yeah. So I remember I would walk in there and there's like that wall of different costumes, right? And I'd be like, I want that one, but the costumes were so fucking expensive for no fucking reason.
Yeah.
And so I feel like my family, like I wanted to be like really creative, you know. I wanted to have a creative costume, look awesome, and like, you know, impress my friends when I was in elementary school. But like my parents didn't have time to make creative costumes. I didn't know how, and I feel like my family couldn't really like afford the really expensive ones. So if I ever got costumes, it was like I'll get one and like wear it for multiple years. But yeah, and we would go there, and maybe like I'd spray my hair with some sort of coloring spray or something.
Ooh. Sometimes I would get scared to walk into that store though.
Me too. There's some scary shit in there, and they have to put it in the front. They couldn't put it in the back.
No, they couldn't. I hate all of these like motion sensor shit. Like, I don't want that hand to move when I walk by it.
I don't want that hand to move when I put my hand in the candy bowl. Okay.
No, I please like, do not touch me.
No, there's like I'm like an innocent trick-or-treater. I'm like, wow, look at this bowl of candy. And they're like, put your hand in it, get as much as you want. I'm like, wow, what a nice person. And this bitch scares me and they're laughing. Like, that's fucked up. Okay. I would never do that to strangers.
Right. Like I want the candy really badly. So now you're going to take this opportunity to try to scare me. Like I have lost trust. Okay.
That's fucked up. Please, that's trauma.
There's trauma everywhere in our childhood, okay?
Honestly.
Even these holidays.
But I remember walking into a Spirit store, and like I remember there was like it'd be hanging from walls too, like skulls and like ghouls and shit.
Yeah.
And like I'd walk in like covering my eyes until I got to the costume area or something. Like, obviously Tanisha and I, we can't handle spooky things very well. Okay.
If you can't tell already, like no, we are not a fan of the spooky shit. But what I am a fan of though is trick-or-treating for sure. I mean, I think candy was the highlight. Mm-hmm. I love sugar. Okay. And that's what got me by when I was a child, I think. I used to go with my friends every year, all of the time, until we all decided in like silent mutual agreement that we were too old to go. And then we stopped going. Right.
Oh
yeah. I mean, like it was fine. Cause I was like, I'm older. Like I'm cool. Like
to go.
I don't fucking need candy.
I'm an adult. Yeah, exactly.
At like 15, I'm like, I'm an adult.
Oh my God. Young Tanisha, little did you know.
Yeah, I didn't know shit back then. I also went in college though, but it was trick-or-treating for UNICEF.
That's right.
Yeah, we were doing a fundraiser, and it's where you ask for donations to a charity instead of candy when you go trick-or-treating.
Yeah.
And I remember there was a guy, his name was Calvin. He wore a cow costume And whenever Calvin would go up and like talk to the people at the door, they would give more money. So we were like, this is cash cow Calvin.
Oh my like, God, cash
he's
cow.
He's our Calvin. Cash cow. Yes. So
CCC.
I'm sorry, Calvin. I did not ask you if you could be mentioned, but
he's fine.
I think this puts you in a great light, honestly.
Yeah.
Calvin is a good luck charm.
He is a cash cow. That's all we want.
He's a cash cow. Yeah.
Companies would die to be you.
Would die.
For me, trick-or-treating, I would go with my family. I think I went with like my family until I was in maybe like middle school, and I actually really cherished going with my dad. My dad is like my best friend. I love him. And I feel like when I was getting older and it was kind of more normalized to go with your friends rather than your family or your parent, I was like, I want to go with my dad still though. Like maybe I'll go trick-or-treating with my dad for an hour and then my friends, but like it didn't happen because my dad was like, just go. He's so chill. He's like, just go. You know, I think he just wanted to get rid of me too, but that's fine. But I really had fun trick-or-treating. My neighborhood was very festive. Like we had in my neighborhood and also the neighboring neighborhoods, they were all like decorating their houses, always participated. Most houses were like giving out candy and stuff. And it was really safe, like to just walk around. Like my parents like trusted us and the friend group to like go in that area. So we would always just go out for a few hours, come back, and then like roll out our bags and throw all our candy on the floor and like organize, like, do you want this? Do you want that? Oh, let's take this. Who got more candy and stuff?
Oh my God.
Did you do that?
Yeah, dude, I'm getting like flashbacks of all the times I went trick-or-treating.
Yeah.
What did you use to carry your candy around in?
You know, I think I would use a plastic bag, but I would always feel self-conscious because other people had like nicer bags, but like all I could have was a plastic bag. How about you?
I mean, I remember people having like those plastic jack-o'-lantern, like bowl, like buckets. Yeah, buckets. And I didn't get those. But what I did do, I think my mom suggested, like, she was like, just bring a pillowcase. It's a fucking big bag. And I was like, that's so smart, mom. Oh my so God. That's what we did.
And it goes with the theme. Maybe I did pillowcase too. It was like pillowcase or plastic bag. Like, I did remember though, like I wanted that jack-o'-lantern. Like that was my goal. I'm like, why can't I fucking have it, mom?
Yeah.
And she's like, bitch, you only going to use it once a year. And I'm like, but I want it, you know? So
if I was like, American dream is that plastic jack-o'-lantern.
Fucking jack-o'-lantern. When I have kids, I will get them the jack-o'-lantern.
We got to do for our kids what we never got ourselves.
Yeah, that's but they the also thing. Need to suffer a little bit to appreciate their life. You know what I mean?
Just a little bit, just a little bit. When you were talking about going with your dad, I was thinking when I used to go when I was like little. Oh yeah, since I'm not wearing a costume today, I do have a picture of little Tanisha wearing a costume. I don't know if you guys can see it, but like that's pretty hard.
There you go. There you go.
Oh, there she is, little what Tanisha is that with her costume? Bangs.
Oh my God.
This is a traditional Thai costume, but I remembered that I wore it for Halloween, like just by looking at this picture, because I'm wearing a white turtleneck under this traditional costume.
Cute. Oh my God.
That's supposed to be like a tube top, okay? But dude, because it's cold, I am wearing a white turtleneck underneath.
Dude, your hair looks like those hats that jockeys wear.
I know what you mean, but I don't know what they're called. Yeah.
I don't either, but they're like the helmet hats.
You're correct. Thing.
It looks just like that. She's a Thai jockey, that costume.
Ooh, yes. If you guys didn't know, like I had bangs, like straight across bangs, like my entire life.
So did every other Asian person.
We have so much in common, guys. This is amazing.
Who had that bowl cut haircut? Everyone. Comment below. Someone told me that if we want more engagement, we need to directly ask. And it's not like we haven't been asking, but here is my ask. You got a bowl cut when you're younger? Comment that shit. Like me too. Jockey hat helmet for life.
Oh my God. When I was little though, and I went trick-or-treating with my parents, I was the kid that was so fucking shy that I wouldn't even say trick-or-treat. Oh like God. I was like, I just want candy. Give me candy. Why do I have to say it?
Like I'm not going to give in to this kind of conspiracy or something.
I think I was so shy. I don't think I was that intelligent. Okay, Kim, I do not give her that much credit. But like, I remember that my parents, like my mom, had to like nudge my shoulder a little bit to like get me to fucking talk. And then, so I was happy when like there were a group of kids already at the door, so I could just run in and collectively say it with them. This is when I was like six, okay, like when I was a baby. But saying thank you after, that was no problem because I got to run the fuck away after I said it. We didn't go in our neighborhood because people didn't really have their lights on. Like I feel like a lot of the children moved away before I got to the age that I could go and trick-or-treat. So we went to those big ass houses in the hills.
I heard they get better candy up there.
Yes, those people give out that good shit. Okay, I don't want no miniature size things. Okay, I'm already fun sized. I do not need more of that.
I want that big bar.
Give me that king size bar. Okay. Give me those four Kit Kats in a row instead of two. Okay. That's what I want. So we had to pick and choose our places where we went so we could get the good stuff.
You know, actually, that was a strategy. Like, if you want good candy, go to the country club. You know, the country club was a little far from me. I did have friends there, but I didn't want to drive all the way there. Like I did enjoy just walking out of my house, walking around and then coming home.
It's easy. Yeah.
Yeah. But like some people were really strategic about it. Like I'm going to hit this place, hit it as in like, you know, trick or treating, not hit it as in robbery. God. Okay. Like Jesus. I'm going to attend this place and trick or treat and then go to this other place and joyfully, safely, calmly trick or treat. Okay.
Wow. I will politely ask for candy. I will exactly. not be aggressive.
Oh my God. Yeah. So a lot of people did strategize, but I was like more than happy with what I could get around my area.
Oh my God. I love that.
Yeah.
I mean, my parents, they were too tired to walk sometimes. So they would just drop me off and I would go down to a door with a light. And then I would get back in the car and then we'd go to another house with the light because sometimes it was spaced so far apart. So I understand the convenience of being like in your own area for sure.
Yeah.
But
do you have a favorite Halloween candy?
A favorite Halloween? Okay. I have several. I lean towards chocolate and sour candies. So for chocolate. Me too. Kim-Mai, we're the same person.
Oh my gosh. Sure.
Okay. So for chocolate. Do you guys know what 100 grand bars are? Do you know what those are?
I mean, I do, but I don't think I've ever tried one.
It's fucking delicious. Okay, let me describe it to you. Okay. Yes. Okay. So do you guys know what a crunch bar is? Like it's milk chocolate with Rice Krispies in it, right?
Yes, I do.
Yes. So imagine that has like, it's hollowed out and then inside there's chewy caramel. Fucking delicious. Okay.
Okay.
What kind of chocolate candy do you like?
So I used to really enjoy Snickers, Twix, Kit Kats, Milky Way. Yes.
Wow.
Those Three Musketeers, things like that. Yeah. But I will say that like after looking back at this, I think my taste was very skewed to like what my friends wanted or like what my friends like. So like I remembered liking Twix. And I ate it, but then I remember like my friend said like, oh, I really love Twix. So she would like try to take everyone's Twix. And I'm like, bro, like, let me try some too. So I tried it. And I was like, no, it's good. I want some too. And so I was like eating Twix and Snickers because they're kind of similar.
Yeah.
And then Kit Kats. Oh, actually, well, I mean, I think Kit Kats are like pretty good in general. But like now I feel like I never really loved candy, but it could be that my taste has changed. You know, it could be it. So those are the chocolates that I did enjoy, though.
I think my taste did change also because now that I'm older, a lot of sugar, like it's difficult for me to take more than like one bite of candy, even if I want to eat more.
Me too.
But then I also like sour candy too.
Yeah.
Me too. So sour gummy worms will be my ride or die for the rest of my life.
Yes, sour gummy worms, but also I don't know what it's called. It comes in like blue, green, and red, and they're like individually packaged. They're kind of like twisted and they're sour.
They're twisted?
They're like flatly twisted.
Are they sour punch straws? Is that
yes.
what it is?
Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Sour punch, like the straws are good, but also like the flat ones too that are individually wrapped. So I really, really like those. Like I think I like them now too. Like if you give me some, I will eat it. Specifically the blue one, I don't know if it's because I like the taste or because I like the color blue, but other than the chocolate that I just mentioned, those were the other notable ones that I really like to enjoy.
I feel like I was conditioned as a child to think of blue as the best flavor and everything else was far less superior.
Yeah, I think so. I keep touching my hood because I'm not used to having anything in my head. And I'm also afraid of the eyes. So every time I look at myself, if you notice that I'm covering the owl's eyes, it's because it comforts me. But let's move on.
Kim-Mai will tell you about her story with owls later on.
Yeah, another time. Too spooky another for time. Today. Did you have any like favorite Halloween costumes or like memorable ones?
So I have this whole thing about costumes, okay? Every year, I'm like, I'm not going to dress up. Why am I going to dress up and like be what I was last year or like buy something new? Like, I'm only going to wear it once. Like, why?
Right? What a practical kid.
Yeah. But then it gets closer to Halloween and I start getting excited and I'm like, oh, but everyone else is going to dress up.
That'll do you.
So, yeah. I always have last minute costumes though. Like, that's the thing. Like, I think if I planned more, it would be a little bit better, but instead they always come out like kind of half-assed. And so they never live up to the hype that I create for myself.
Yeah.
I remember though that when you, me and Mindy, when we were in college, we decided to be the Powerpuff Girls.
That was
and
so cute.
We made our own costumes. Yeah, that was really cute.
That was really fun.
I loved that.
Yeah, we were the Powerpuff Girls, and we also had, like, the Rowdy Rough Boys, and also Professor X. Oh, is that his name?
Yeah.
You know what's weird?
What?
Is that Dave was Professor X, so he technically was your dad.
Ew!
Dude.
My mind did not go there at all. What?
What's with you and family shit, okay? If y'all remember in past episodes.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. My mind didn't even go there. Yeah, so.
Mine didn't go there until today when I was, like, typing it out. Great. Like Powerpuff Girls, Rowdy Rough Boys, and the dad. And I was like, the dad?
Oh my god. In my mind when I was typing, I was like, oh, the professor, yeah, it was Dave. But I didn't think my dad was Dave, you know?
Yeah. Well, you know what? There's no blood relation there. You were a chemical. We were chemicals.
Yeah, let's continue to reiterate that there is no blood relation with any of these stories. Okay, please. I was Blossom and
I was
Mindy
Bubbles.
Was Buttercup. Yeah. And Kim-Mai was Bubbles.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, a couple other people. The names escape me, but we did have Rowdy Rough Boys.
Yeah. It was cute though. It was really cute. That was one of my favorite costumes because one, we made it ourselves. It was cute. Yeah. We all bought like an oversized shirt and then made tutus and then, that's pretty much all it was like a dress. So you know how like the Powerpuff Girls have like dresses. So we had like, we just got a big shirt, painted a black stripe on it. And then the tutu is like the rest of the dress. So it was cute.
It was so cute and very, very cost effective to make.
Yeah,
very
it was.
Fun. Yeah. You should definitely post some of those pictures for everyone to see.
I will. Yeah. I will. Did you have any other costumes that you liked?
So I also remember that I was Lara Croft for 1 year. This is in college though, because I was invited to a Halloween party and I was like, it's last minute again. What the fuck do I do?
Oh my God.
So I was like, okay, tank top, short shorts, belt around my thigh, some aviators and a braid. And I'm like, ta-da, I'm Angelina motherfucking Jolie, bitch.
Oh my God.
So easy. And then I just took some like eyeshadow and like an eye pencil and I just rubbed it on my body as dirt.
Wow. Crafty.
Yeah. I've been running around in those tombs. You know what I'm saying? Like,
there you go. You just had to stop by for this casual party.
Yes. She got to have fun too. Okay. Croft busy, but she got to have fun.
Yeah. You know, got to raid some tombs at 8, but party at 9. That's
wow. Did you have any other favorites?
I did. I don't think I mentioned any favorites of mine. Oh, except for that, the one that you mentioned. But I guess I'll start in elementary school. Long ago, in a land far away called San Jose. Wow, that rhymed. But anyways.
She's a poet.
One of my all-time favorites from what I remember in elementary school was this pink princess costume, okay? It came in this cute chest, and like it was a pretty big chest, and it had a handle so you could like carry it around, and when you opened it, it had like the dress folded inside. It came with lace gloves, a tiara, earrings, a necklace, I think. Wow. And it was like the most extra costume I've ever worn and received, but it was so cute. Like, I loved it so much. Like, I felt so beautiful. So like, I felt like a princess in it. And so I would say that that's like my favorite costume, or like the best memory I've had, because like I mentioned earlier, my family couldn't really afford or didn't want to expend on a costume every year. So mm-hmm. I feel like that one was something that like I forgot who got it for me, either like my dad or my uncle. They got that and I was like really surprised, and I was so excited to wear it to school and stuff. I think I have pictures of it too. Maybe I'll share it as well. But that is one of my favorites. And then when I was in college, Brian and I, we dressed up as he was Peter Pan and I was Wendy.
Oh yeah.
So I like went on Amazon. I found this like cute blue dress and we wore it to Disneyland because we went with his niece and nephew. So it was like, oh, you know, like dress up for them and stuff. So we have like cute pictures of that. And we like recreated a scene from Peter Pan. And that was really cute. But other than that, I just had like basic ass costumes. Like, raise your hand if you were ever a cat for Halloween. Me.
Same.
But yeah, I've had some like, those are like my highlight costumes in my life so far. But I also feel like I was pretty lazy. Other than those, I did not dress up. Like, it was either all out or not at all.
I want to see baby Mai in a pink princess costume so bad. Please, please share. Please share those pictures.
I'll find it.
I feel like a lot of people are really elaborate with their costumes sometimes. Mm-hmm. And a way that they can be super creative and detail oriented is with like their makeup.
Yeah.
And I wish very badly to be able to do that without having to practice it. That's never going to happen, right?
I know.
But it's so creative. And like, I am in awe of the effort that they put in sometimes.
Yeah, the effort and the skill, because even if I tried to do that, one, I'd have to practice, like you mentioned. But if I were to do that like the day of and I fucked up, I would just wipe all of that shit off.
Yeah.
And I would just call it a day. I'd be like, you know what? I tried my best and my best wasn't good enough. So so the result is no, we're just not continuing with this project.
It's like high pressure situation. Got to get out in like 3 hours. Can it be done? 2.5 hours in, fucking black no. streak across your face. Fuck this, wipe it off.
Rub it on your body, you're the Tomb Raider.
that's actually how it happened. Thank you for exposing. I'm just kidding. At least you have makeup knowledge, okay? I have none. And I remembered a story, not really related, okay, but when we were at Coachella, Kim-Mai, and you were doing your makeup, and the lighting was kind of weird inside. So you were like, Tanisha, is my eyeshadow blended? And I was like, I've never been confronted with this question before. Looks good to me. And then you showed like Patty for somebody else. And they were like, nah, you got to do that again, girl. And I was like, damn, I know nothing. Nothing about makeup. Thank you,
Tanisha, for trying to sabotage my Coachella. I'm just kidding.
Oh my God. Yeah. Out of spite, not because of like lack of knowledge or anything like that.
Like, one eye is visibly different than the other. Bitch, you look great.
I tried my best, okay? I looked at that like through the eyes of someone who had never done makeup before, and I was like, looks fire, girl. You do.
Color showed up. Yes, exactly. That is the goal.
Yeah, I can't tell the difference between blended and unblended shadow, I guess. I mean, while we're talking about Halloween, I think we can get into some spooky shit.
While we're talking about Halloween, that's what this episode's fucking about, Tanisha. Oh, we're not going anywhere else.
Some spooky shit, some scary shit. Okay, Kim-Mai, you don't have to expose my transitions like that. Okay, I'm trying here.
How good are you with scary shit?
Bruh, I am not good with scary shit, okay?
No.
No, not
I'm good. Terrible as well. I'm easily startled. I'm easily broken.
Okay. We're not trying to make Halloween sound so sad. It's just, it's a fact of life sometimes for us.
This is the type of life I must live, okay? So I'm just sharing my honest truth. Look at me, I'm covering these fucking owl eyes, okay?
I'm trying not to laugh when you keep doing that, okay? Spoiler alert, Kim-Mai is scared of owls, you guys, okay?
That doesn't give you the permission to send me owls, okay? Fuck off. Please, if you don't decide to do that. That's fucked up.
I Googled baby owls the other day thinking they would be cute. They're so fucking scary, bro. Like, I'm with you. Still scary.
Anyways.
I mean, yeah, we're the same person. I am not good with scary shit. The highest level of scary I can do is probably like slightly unsettling. That's the level. Any higher than that, I'm like, I don't think I can go there.
Cannot function.
Level 4 scary is maybe my like my limit, okay? But then my mind and my imagination will take it to like level 10 in like 10 seconds. So it's really my own fault that I'm scared of shit, honestly.
This is the life we live. We didn't say it was easy.
Oh my God, first world problems. Yeah, my imagination just plays tricks on me and makes everything way worse. So
yeah, honestly, same here. Like when I watch or hear anything scary, and for me scary is like paranormal or like scary images, things like that, that's scary. Mm-hmm. Or you know, pop-ups and shit, that's scary to me. And when I see or hear about that, that lives in me for the rest of my life, okay? It decides to pay, or no, actually doesn't even pay, it stays rent-free in my mind. Oh my solidly God. For about a week. After a week, it starts to fade away, decides to kind of like move into some boxes in the back of my brain, and then casually comes out and says, surprise, bitch, once in a while, just to fuck with me, okay?
That was the most beautiful metaphor I've ever heard in my entire life. I only started laughing in the beginning because I was thinking about how much of a wimp both Kim-Mai and I are. Like, we are just can't handle shit, can't handle a moving company, like putting shit into our brains that stay there forever.
No.
Cannot handle.
I mean, I'm going to be honest right now, as I'm speaking about this with the lights off, I'm a little scared.
Me too. I'm fucking sitting in the dark and like, we're about to share some scary stories, okay?
Yeah. But we're doing it for you.
The sacrifices that we make to put this content out there, this very important content that needs to be heard. Scary movies are also not my jam. Like, I cannot handle horror at all. I will have nightmares for days also. And then it fades away and comes back and says, surprise, bitch. Same.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Gore is actually okay with me, like blood and guts, whatever.
No, thank you.
No, not for you.
No.
Mm-hmm. The thing that scares me the most, I think, is like psychological shit and torture. Like, I don't like watching those in any form, honestly. Like, that is not for me. And I think things that can happen in real life are the scariest for me. So like, if it's not supernatural, then I'm scared. I'm okay, just laughing because you're covering the owl eyes again.
I got scared. Okay. Maybe we're like the opposite in that case. You know, like I can't do gore. Psychological is okay. And paranormal shit. Because as I've mentioned before, I do believe that in ghosts. I'm not going to talk about it anymore, okay? But I believe that there's something else out there. And we'd be very, 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 very naive to think that there's not. Okay, but anyways. Anyways. I just remember like in elementary school, do you remember those like scary stories to tell in the dark? Stop. Those books?
Stop.
My teacher would read that shit to us around Halloween time.
What the fuck?
Yeah, I don't remember which teacher, but I just remembered that like it was story time and she would read that shit. And then like my friends would borrow it from the library. Like, excuse me, why did you have those books in elementary school? You need to have those books banned because like those stories, again, somewhere deep inside me, they come to visit every once in a while, okay, just to fuck shit up. Like, you're having a good day, well, remember that poem where it says, if you laugh when a hearse passes by, you may be the next to die? Do you remember that poem? Not me laughing around hearses, okay? I see a hearse, I'm like, bitch, I'm silent, okay? And then, you know, just casually at Disneyland or something, And then it goes, hello, remember the story about the wife with the ribbon around her neck and her husband decides to take that shit off when she said don't and her head falls into her lap? Have a good time on Space Mountain. Okay. Oh my
God. And then, I'm scared. Stop. Yeah. Jeez.
See, that shit, it's in me and it's in all of us if we have ever read those stories.
Yeah, thank you for bringing that back to the forefront of my mind. I really appreciate that. Fucking ribbon around the neck. That was some scary ass shit.
I'm sweating. Okay,
that story.
I'm sweating.
Back sweat. Okay, some like butt sweat. I'm scared. Okay. A little scary. I mean, I have something to share too. If you are ready to listen after scaring me, okay, it's my turn. Okay.
Oh shit. All right.
As I have said, cannot handle horror movies. But no. One day, my parents and I, we always eat dinner together. Okay. And they were like, okay, so we know that you're going to go to bed soon. So we're just going to put on this scary movie. Okay.
Do they do that and for fun?
I think my dad just likes to watch all different kinds of movies. So like, he was like, oh, look, something I haven't seen before. Right. And it happens to be something that I fucking hate.
Jesus.
He puts on the movie and I am not looking at the screen. I'm like, I'm going to fucking finish my dinner and I'm going to go upstairs. Okay. I'm going to like run away. I decide to look up at the screen for 1 minute because they're just explaining like some backstory. It doesn't sound too creepy.
Yeah.
As soon as I look up, okay, I want you to imagine this. This is what I saw on the screen. I'm sorry, Kim-Mai, but this is what I saw. The camera's point of view. Okay, imagine you have that view. You are walking through a dark, wooded area at night. You see this house in the distance with like one light on. She's putting post-its on the owl eyes. That's why I'm laughing. Oh my God. I'm crying, Kim-Mai, like, please. I just wanted to tell my scary story.
I got scared even more, okay? As you were telling the story.
Oh my God, I'm sorry I did this to you. Okay, let me finish this. I'm sweating. Let me finish this story. Okay. You are walking through the woods. I'm not going to look at you, Kim-Mai. I can't. Okay. You're walking through the woods at night and it's dark. You see a cabin in the distance with one light on and you are walking on the path towards the cabin. Okay.
Fucking run.
Please. I'm scared, so I'm laughing. That's why I'm laughing. Okay. You see a garbage bag, like a huge ass garbage bag on the side of the trail.
I'm scared.
And you're like, oh, that's interesting. And then you try to look away, but then out of the corner of your eye, you see it move a little bit by itself.
Oh, no.
And then this person decides to go up to the bag and look inside. And there is a dismembered body of a young woman in there.
Oh my God.
And you see her decapitated head.
Ew, 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 ew.
Her head has red hair. Okay, ew. She is a redhead.
Oh no.
And you want to look at it longer for some fucking reason.
Oh my God.
And all of a sudden, she fucking turns and looks at you and says some shit. I know.
Oh no.
I'm sorry, but that is also... I probably saw that when I was in middle school and it has stuck with me until now. And sometimes if I think about it too hard at night, that is the vision that comes up for me. Nightmares for life.
Well, fuck you.
So that is why I want to share my trauma with all of you so we can like relate. I'm just kidding. I hope you don't remember this, but also like, welcome to my world and why I don't like scary movies. I can't look at you because the fact that you covered the owl eyes with post-its is so funny to me. Okay.
I'm trying to
set the mood with a scary story. And she's just like, let me just put these here.
I was getting too scared and I was getting excessively sweaty. I needed to ease my tension a little bit.
I'm sweating. Okay. My lights are feeling hotter. Okay.
Oh gosh. Oh my goodness. But Damn, like honestly, with scary movies, sometimes I'm like interested in the storylines, right? Like, ooh, like what is the plot of this? So I rarely ever watch scary movies, but if I am interested, I will go and read the synopsis or the plot. Or, yeah. Or
Me
like, I think
too.
there's like, what is it? The Haunting of Hill House and whatever, like that Netflix show. I would read about it just to mentally prepare myself because like it was just too much and I knew something was coming. The first one was scarier than the second season. And so I was all sorts of fucked up and reading that shit online. Okay. And like preparing myself. I don't care about ruining the plot and the story for me. I care about my mental health. Okay. And if I need to read that, if I need to read that shit to prepare myself and feel a little happier in life, like let me do that, okay?
He's
But
like, let me mentally prepare myself so like I don't, you know, spiral
yeah,
into depression later on in life.
exactly. No depresso espresso over here. And I have a like scary movie experience.
No.
So it's not a scene from a movie. This is
Okay.
funnier than what you
Sorry. I'm
described.
sorry.
I mean, I believe it's funny. It was a little traumatizing, but after a few years, the trauma turns into laughs, right? Is that how it works?
That's
Anyways,
what we hope for.
so I was an intern, and this is with Shalini. Y'all have heard of Shalini before, and another friend named Sachi. She was also an intern. So we were all really close. And Sachi really wanted to go see this one scary movie. I forgot what it's called. I tried to Google it and then I just instant fear, okay? Because
Oh,
the
man.
title was like not Drag Me to Hell, but it was like something like evil. And I don't know. Okay. So like that wasn't fun when I was Googling it at work. Okay. But there's a scary movie and she wanted to see it. And Shalini and I were like, okay, fine. And I was like, fine, let's go. You know, we don't get to hang out outside of work often. And then we decide to go. And this movie has been out for a while. So, like, not many people were going to see it. But last minute, Sachi bails. And so, Shalini and I, like, we're kind of like already set to go. And
Oh
there's this
my
other
God.
girl who is an intern there as well. But, like, she doesn't really talk to people. So, we were like, oh, let's invite her. So, you know, she can get familiar. We can all be friends. So we invite her and she's like, yeah, cool, I'll go. So it's us three, me, Shalini, and the other girl. Shalini and I, before we get to the theater, we get tea pumps, which is like boba. And tea pumps, like, I don't know why, something about it makes me fucking pee like a lot. So before I went to the theater inside, I peed and like I just need to prepare myself because I didn't want to leave during the movie. So we go into the movie theater and no one's in there. It's literally just us three. And then a few minutes before the movie starts, a man walks in and the whole theater is empty, but he decides to sit at the end of our row.
Ew.
Yeah, you know, red
No.
flag, but like also it's fine. And so us three we're in like the middle of that row and we're watching the movie. I'm freaking out. And Shalini goes, I need to go to the bathroom. And I'm like, bitch, don't leave me. And she's like, I really fucking have to pee. And I was like, hurry the fuck up. I'm scared. But she's like, you know, it's fine. You have the other girl there. Like, you'll be good. I'm like, yeah, you're right. Okay, go. And so this is like beginning to be like the peak of the scary movie. Like, literally, whatever shit is happening like in front of me at this time while Shalini's in the bathroom. And the other girl stands up and leaves. No explanation, doesn't look back.
Oh
As
my
and
God.
I'm confused. By the time I realize that she's gone, she's gone, okay? And I'm in the theater by myself with this man at the end of the row as shit is happening. Lights are flashing. Things are conspiring in front of me and I'm like freaking the fuck out. I'm just like, okay, I know stranger danger, but I'm so scared I may make a friend with that man. I didn't do that, but I was very close because I was scared. Okay. And then Shalini comes back when like everything's over and she's like, who the fuck is that girl? And I'm like, I'm just unstable at that point. Like I had to experience too much alone. Okay.
Oh my
And
God.
you know, if you hate scary movies and you're in an empty theater with a strange man at the end of the row and the climax is occurring and scary shit is happening, that'll scar you. And you know what? It's fine. Like now when I talk to Shalini about it, we're just like, fuck that girl. I mean, she was really nice, but also like, why didn't you explain to me why you're leaving? Because like, I could have left with you. I suffered, but it's fine. So that's my experience with a scary movie. And honestly, I heard that watching scary movies with me makes the scary movie scarier because I scream all the time. I'm flinching all the time. Like I guess it's not a fun time when that happens.
I mean, I have an experience with that though. I don't think you make it scarier, but when I hear other people scream around me, I feel like I also have to scream. Even if I'm not scared, I'm just like, I need to join in, you know, like harmonize or something, some shit. But
you go high, I go low, let's go, okay?
But I remember that we were at board retreat, I think, and you were sitting on the couch like next to me and some other guy, and you just kept like gripping our arms like when shit would happen. Mm-hmm. But that time it kind of made me laugh because the scary movie wasn't like that bad. So I couldn't enjoy your reaction.
I couldn't handle gory, but she was okay with gory.
That's true, I guess. You have a good point there. But yeah. I think I would recommend if you want to see a scary movie, take Kim-Mai only if she wants to go. Only if there is consent. Okay, but like I think it's a good time when she's there.
Yeah, like I mean I'm interested. I just need to be mentally prepared, and I probably also need someone to sleep next to me. Like I think in high school I was watching a scary movie with Trang and like a few other friends, and I refused to let Trang leave. I was like, Trang, you need to sleep over because I cannot sleep alone. And she was just like, what the fuck? At that time Trang slept over all the time though, so it wasn't strange. Uh-huh. But that day specifically I was like, you're not going home today. Like I'll take you to school the next day, it's fine. I was traumatized.
I think when I would watch scary movies with like other high school friends, right? Mm-hmm. I would try to play it off and be like, this doesn't scare me. You know, like
no, I'm not fine. At all.
Through but really tears. My eyes were closed the entire fucking time, and like I was just like pretending to act scared when everyone else would, because it's like I'm watching it.
Oh my gosh. Yeah.
Played it off there.
It's like that second of a delay. Someone screams and you're like, oh, it's time to scream. Ah!
Yeah, that was me. I was like, oh no. You know.
Oh my god, I can't believe that happened, but has no idea what actually happened.
Exactly. Because I want to preserve my mental health. Okay.
There you go. Mental health is important. We're gonna preach that every episode.
So my friend Natasha, she can handle scary things better than I can. So the only reason I watched scary movies at all during my childhood was because she wanted me to. Okay. Uh-huh. That is the only reason. And she has also asked me to go to horror nights many, many, many times. And every fucking year I was like, no, no, fuck no. Hell no, bitch, not going, right? But she was nice about it. She was like, okay, fine. But like, she would still ask me every year.
Yeah.
And I always said, like, I will never go. And if I go, it will only be with her, because I promised her, like, you are the only person, because like, I don't even want to do this for myself. Okay. No. I went once, actually, and I am never fucking going to go back. Let me tell you how I ended up at Horror Nights. Okay, Kim-Mai? I didn't want to go, but I was in a relationship at the time, and this person really wanted me to go, and I went. I eventually gave in after giving my explanation about Natasha and being scared and shit. I eventually gave in because I was scared he would be mad at me, which is a fucking terrible reason.
Red flag.
Yeah, red flag and everything, okay? If you're scared that your SO is going to be mad at you, like, unreasonably, that is a reason to run away. But anyway, yeah, I didn't want to go, but I went, and I had an experience. Have you guys ever been to Horror Nights? Have you been to Horror Nights, Kim-Mai?
Yeah, I have.
You have? Okay.
Yeah.
So the way that it works is when you go in first, there is a big open area where actors can like run up to you like and scare you, right? Like dressed in costume and makeup and everything. Uh-huh. And I was so nervous about that part. Like I had been nervous the entire week before going. And then I got in there and I was like, it's okay. I'm cool. I got my man here. Like I'm good. I got other people around me. But then when people started coming up to me and scaring me, like, I just lost my shit. I fucking, like, booked it down the avenue, like where they can scare you. And like, I ran and I screamed and I was like, I can't take this, right? I was trying not to do that the whole time because I knew that when you act scared, like they pick on you.
Yeah, God.
Right? But like, I couldn't hold it in anymore because I think I was just like adrenaline the whole fucking time, right?
Yeah.
And so I ran and then they chased me, of course, and it was scary. But then I got over it and it was okay. And then I didn't scream for the rest of the time, but that was the beginning.
You have to like fake it till you make it.
Yeah, but I faked it so hard that I couldn't fake it anymore and it just had to come out.
Oh no.
And then I also went on the terror tram. Mm-hmm. And what they don't tell you online or anywhere is that you fucking have to get out of the tram at some point and you have to start walking through an outdoor maze. And I almost lost my shit because first of all, my SO at the time, he fucking lied to me about like a bunch of shit that was going to happen, which is not cool. Okay. Cause I didn't even want to be there. No, yeah. But that wasn't as bad as the maze we went into that was indoors, because at least outdoors, I felt like I could run the fuck away if something happened. Yeah. But indoors, I was like, I'm fucking trapped and I'm going to die
here. Oh my gosh.
Thankfully we only went through one indoor maze and then we left, and I had never been so fucking happy in my entire life to leave.
Oh my God. Jesus.
So that was my experience with Horror Nights.
Oh my God.
What about you?
I mean, so I've been to Horror Nights, twice in my hometown, and I went twice with like groups of friends. And I mean, from my memory, I did have fun, but I was also very scared. Like, I remember we were in like a corn maze and like, we were like linking with like friends. Cause like sometimes it's like narrow, so I can only link arms with like one friend. So I was like linking my arms with like one friend. And then I saw the person hiding, like he was up against the corn wall, just like this, like trying to blend in, but like not blending in at all. Okay. And so I saw him, I was like, oh my God, like that's a person, right? Like I see them. And my friend turns and he's like, oh. And then the guy like comes out and scares me, and I like freak the fuck out, even though I saw him. Like I was like,
I'm this like bitch, that too.
Yeah, I was like, this bitch is terrible at hiding, but like, oh, surprise, like I still got scared. So yeah, yes, I'm very easily startled, okay? Even when it's in front of me, I'll still get scared. I'm not faking it, okay? Why would I fake this? This is the type of reaction that is just ingrained in me. And I don't like expending that much energy for no reason, okay?
Yeah.
But also another time, like I remember the inside mazes, there's one that was like the slaughterhouse. So imagine I'm terrible with gore. They like tied kind of like damp towels and like hung them from the ceiling to be like intestines.
Ew.
Yeah. And so as I was going through it, like I knew that they were not intestines, but I couldn't handle them on me. So I was literally holding onto my friend's arm and like crouching and basically crawling under it because I could not handle it, even though I knew it was like fake.
Mm-hmm.
And then like another time, because I was so fucking scared, they also came after me. Like they were like, oh, this bitch, she's jittery. Like she's easily scarable. Let me make my night worth. I came here to scare a bitch and this is a bitch to scare. Okay. And so they would follow me. And one time we were on the way out, and I was like, I think I was with like Trang or Claire or something. And I was just so happy that we're leaving. And it was like, I was like, okay, cool. It's been a chill night. And then this guy, he was wearing like knee pads and like a scary costume. And he like kind of like runs and like slides in front of me on his knee pad. So it makes a loud noise and he's very close.
God.
So like he does that and I literally book it. Like I'm like linking arms with my friend and I book it. And like, I'm running away with my hands up. I'm running past these two kids who are bouncing up, like throwing a basketball up and down, and as I run past, I hit the basketball out of their hands, and I'm scared. Why do they have a basketball? Why are they in my way? They need to hold that shit, okay? It is not my fault. But yes, that did happen. I knocked a basketball out of someone's hand because they were unprepared.
When you said why, I thought you were going to be like, why am I here? But you said, why do they have a basketball? I agree with you. I just didn't expect you to say that. Oh my God.
I mean, I'm open to going to Horror Nights, but I'm also like, I would be so jittery and anxious the whole night. And at the end of the night, I'll probably be like, that was cool. But during the whole time, I'll probably be the most fucking annoying person ever because I'm so scared. But that's my time with Horror Nights.
I'm laughing at you, like running with your hands up, but also like laughing at myself because that's how I was running at like Universal Studios. Okay.
She's like, bitch, same.
I really tried to hold that shit in, but it's like fight or flight, bitch. You can't. Adrenaline. Like,
yeah, it's ingrained. Like, I'm only here because my ancestors, survival of the fittest. Okay. So I wasn't made to just sit there and accept danger. I was made to fucking run or fight. And physically, I am not a fighter. So I am a flighter.
You fought that basketball, though. You ran away, that basketball. You fought that.
That basketball had it coming for it. You know?
I think I've never been that scared in my entire life where like I cannot help the reaction from coming out of my body. Do not recommend if you are what we're describing sounds like you. Okay. Yeah. Do not recommend. We're wimps, but at least we know how to keep our mental health in check.
In check. Yeah. In check. It's all about mental health. Okay.
Be nice to yourself. And if that includes nice not to going to Horror Nights, don't go.
Yeah. Don't be swayed to peer pressure, because if you are and you go, it's just a lifetime of trauma. Are they going to compensate you for that? No.
Life lessons.
There you go. Other than Horror Nights and all of that scary shit, I can handle true crime, though. Is that considered scary and horror, though?
I mean, because I was saying that things that could happen in real life are scary to me. Oh,
okay.
Right? So I can see how that could be considered a little spooky. Okay.
Okay. I can see that. I mean, I will say that true crime is not my life, but it's like almost. I'm constant. I don't want to say it's my life because then people will be like testing me and stuff. And I'm like, bitch, I'm not that serious. Okay. But I'm constantly listening to true crime. Like anyone, a crime junkie out there, that is me. I am also a crime junkie. When I listen to that shit, like Bobby decided to stalk Sarah and attack her in her sleep. That shit scares me. I'm like, oh God, do I have a Bobby in my life? Okay, I do have a Bobby in my life and he's a great person. He would never do that or to anyone, okay? But he's a great person. I'm sorry. I thought that was a
Bobby's generic just name. Sitting there like.
But like, just for example, like the shit that they explain, the true crime I listen to though, it doesn't go into the detail of the gore. It focuses on the victim, giving the victims back their name, giving, providing justice, explaining things like that. So that's why I like, that's the true crime shit that I like. I don't like it when people are kind of glorifying like murders. I think that's a little sick. I mean, if that's what you enjoy, yes, okay. That's what you enjoy. But I don't enjoy that. So, but the stories, they stick with me. Like I remember when I was really listening to it 24/7 and I hung out with a friend, I would walk around and I'd pass the trash can and I'd be scared that like there was a body in there, or I'd be hiking and I'd be scared that someone is stalking me. Oh shit. Okay. I don't want to talk about it anymore. I'm getting a little scared.
Okay. Okay.
So you continue.
Okay. So I want to listen to these true crime podcasts and watch these shows just like Kim-Mai. And, I think Natasha likes them too, but I feel like I am going to get nightmares. And I will not be okay. But the closest that I'll probably get for now is like crime TV shows. So like Criminal Minds, Law and Order, SVU. Still pretty heavy, honestly, and like lot of scary stuff. Especially if you're scared of like things that could happen in real life like me. But I think that is my limit for now.
Yeah.
Although I do also want to know like the stories. Like I want to know like the plots of horror films, and I want to know like the stories behind what has happened, mostly so I can protect myself.
Yeah.
Because I do not want to die, right? but that's about as much as I can handle
for true crime. I think I would recommend Crime Junkie to you. I don't know if you've ever listened to it, but they don't focus too much on like the gore. They just talk about the case, what happens, and like focuses on the victim rather than perpetrator, you know?
Okay. I think you also told me about like, what is it? Sword and Scale?
Did you? Oh God. Okay. Sword and Scale. It's good, but there is an episode that I listened and I just have not gone back because that episode, it literally killed a little bit of me. It was a lot to handle, and I have not revisited Sword and Scale properly. Okay. Like I've tried, and I just mentally am not. I don't think I can revisit Sword and Scale anymore because the one podcast episode that I listened from them that one time, ooh, it traumatized me. So be careful. Okay,
I will keep that in mind and will not listen to that podcast. Yeah. But if you guys want to check it out and it sounds like you might be into that, like lifetime of trauma, go ahead and look at it, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, it was fun. It was like not fun, but like it was interesting to listen to until I listened to that one. But so far, Crime Junkie has been there for me. Anatomy of Murder, I love that one as well. Supernatural is another one, but sometimes that scares me too because Supernatural. But I like the person who leads the podcast. So, yeah. But I mean, I think listening to those, I like Crime Junkie because they like give you lessons. They say like, be rude if it protects you, you know, it's okay to lie, buddy system, shit like that.
Yeah.
So I will say that although this is about Halloween, whether you're trick or treating or just going out on a Friday, Saturday night, be careful. You never know what type of ghouls, goblins, or people are out there. Okay. So be careful.
Yeah.
Watch out for your friends, your family, your loved ones, things like that.
Stay safe, guys. Especially because it's Halloween is like a nighttime festivity activity time. More opportunity for shady things to happen. So be careful. Mm-hmm. And to end on like a happier note, if you guys have like a younger person or a little kid that you know or that is in your family, please try your best to make their Halloween and all their holidays like as magical and fun as you possibly can. Mm-hmm. Because eventually they're going to get to a point where they're too old for like all this kid shit or whatever.
Yeah. But
the memories will last forever.
They will. So please, like me in my little pink princess dress.
Yeah.
That's a memory, okay? Give that memory to someone in your life.
That's it for our episode. Thanks for listening.
Follow us on Instagram at kinda.tempted. Subscribe and give us a like on YouTube. And we'll see y'all next time. Bye.
Bye.